Welcome to Insight, produced in partnership with WIPB-TV and Indiana Public Radio at Ball State University. Today we are chatting with Jason Newman, CEO of Boys and Girls Clubs of Muncie. Jason has generously agreed to share some of his experience with us. I'd like to thank you, Jason, for joining us today.
Well, thank you for having me. Always glad to brag about our kids.
So Boys and Girls Clubs is a national organization. It has
Yes.
national programs. And you have quite a range of experiences coming from a Boys and Girls Club in Philadelphia,
Yes.
and now you've been in Muncie for over a year. Talk about the Boys and Girls Clubs, the programs that it has in common, but then let's talk about how Muncie and Philadelphia children have different needs.
Right. Well, the Boys and Girls Clubs of America is a national organization, you're right. We have about 5,500 clubs throughout the country. And we are somewhat international. We are on military bases out of country as well. So for those families that move out of country, there is that little piece of home for our youngest people who serve. What we as the Boys and Girls Club of America strive to do is to enable all young children, all young people, especially those who need us most, to reach their full potentials as productive, caring, and responsible citizens. And we do that through three key areas. And one is academic success, character and leadership, and healthy lifestyles. And then we have hundreds of programs that can fit into one of those three categories, and most of them fit into more than one, to try to give our children just a wide variety of opportunities to learn and grow as individuals.
So when you talk about those three different areas, academics, character and leadership, and healthy lifestyles, let's deconstruct what actually does happen at a Boys and Girls Club.
So one of the programs that every Boys and Girls Club that I've worked for runs every day is Power Hour. Their school is a vitally important resource for our youngest people and for our society in general. But the school day is short, and it doesn't seem that way for a kid, but it is a short day to impart a lot of knowledge. And because there's a wide range of students in every classroom, it is difficult to reach every child in that classroom. And the other side of that as well is that the learning that goes on outside of the classroom, when teachers give homework. When I grew up, we had family members who were there to help us with our homework. With a lot of our members, parents don't have the education themselves, or they don't have the time. And even the parents that have the education and the time, we've changed in the past 15 years on how we're teaching simple things like, you know, multiplication. And I know when I was at the Boys and Girls Club in Philadelphia, I would sit there and help the kids with their math homework, doing things the way I had been taught them. And so we would sit there and we'd be doing multiplication, and I'd help them figure it out the way I had been taught. And the kids would come in the next day and say, you know, everything was marked wrong. And they had the answers right. But the way that we are teaching our students today is show your work, and here's the specific way we want you to do it. And so me and my staff had to go back, and we were watching YouTube videos and taking college level classes to find out how our teachers were teaching our students. That's a resource that we have that a parent working third shift or a parent working two jobs is simply unable to do. So that's something that we want to help our members with. One of the other things, and this comes from my background as an early childhood educator, is that I really hated school. And it started for me in the second grade. I started as an early childhood educator with that goal of I may not be able to affect where a child goes to college because I was working with 2 and 3 year olds, and 15, 16 years down the line, you know, that was going to kind of wear off. What I wanted to focus on with my students was I wanted them to have a reminder that at some point learning was just fun. And that's something that we could do in the early childhood world. And it's something that we really work on at the Boys and Girls Club.
And it's such an important point. In today's economy, you end up with a situation where lifelong acquisition of knowledge is key to prosperity.
Yes.
it wasn't always this way.
Right.
It used to be where if you learned a skill set and you deepened and deepened and deepened that skill set, you were guaranteed a job.
Yes.
Until you retired. Now, that's not how the economy works.
Right.
You acquire a skill, you deploy it, it's utilized, your skills become outdated, and you have to acquire new skills so you can get to a next phase in your career,
right,
so you can keep your income up. So this whole idea of making learning part of the habit is so key to the success and the prosperity of this community and the children.
Yes, and not only to the financial success of our people, but you know, just for the emotional success. One of the things I think that causes a lot of the wanderlust that we see in millennials today is as the stereotype, is that things when they've mastered a skill and there's no place else to go, a lot of them become unhappy and try to move on. I think I was very fortunate in my career with the Boys and Girls Club, is that as I grew in my positions, you know, I started as an early childhood director in the Boys and Girls Club, and that was scary for me. I was going from a preschool teacher to running a school with 94 students and a budget of about $500,000. And these were things I had not had to deal with before. There came a point about 2 or 3 years in where it became formulaic, where it was just, okay, we're doing the same things every day, write this grant, set this schedule, you know, take this class. And, you know, I felt that wanderlust, okay, what's next in life? And I was very fortunate to have mentors in my life at the Boys and Girls Club who said, okay, here are some of the other things that we're doing. Can you help out with this? So I started, you know, when as a preschool director, they wanted me to get involved in helping to train all of the early childhood education staff. They wanted me to get involved in bringing some healthy eating habits with a partnership with the Alliance for a Healthier Generation. And so they started to have me branch out into these other areas. You know, a lot of that involved just sitting there and learning, which again, if it had felt like a school situation, a school setting, I probably might have rebelled against that. But because it was tied directly to not only the work that I was doing, but it expanded my horizons to there is more to education, there's more to helping young people than simply early childhood education, which was where my love was.
So you're helping children to navigate through the difficulties of
yes.
childhood. You help them to succeed. You have a group of people who are part of this organization. Talk a little bit about your board composition.
Well, we have a very strong board. We have, right now, it's about 21 people.
21 people, and from different professions and
yes.
backgrounds throughout Muncie.
Yes, so we have our current board president, BJ McKay, is a corporate consultant, a sales consultant, and he runs a CrossFit gym on Wheeling Avenue. My board vice president is Watasha Barnes Griffin, who is the CEO of the YWCA. We have people in business, we have teachers, we have lawyers, we have people who work in other nonprofits, just a beautiful cross-section of the city of
with
Muncie.
Different sensibilities, with
yes.
different priorities, with different ideas of how the org, but they come together and they talk it out.
Yes.
And they work with you.
Yes.
What is next for the Boys and Girls Club here in Muncie?
Well, right now we have, in the past 14 months, we have grown from three sites to five. So right now we are at our Madison Street location, our Bewley Clubhouse, Southside and Northside Middle School, and Central High School. What's next is we would like to enter into the partnership again with the elementary schools of our city. I think there is room in our city in our schools, for the YMCA and the Boys and Girls Club and whatever Ball State University wants to run as after school programs. I use a simple statistic. We see about 250 kids every day. The YMCA sees about a similar number of kids. Between the two of us, we are serving 10% of our school population in after-school programming. There are about 5,000 kids in Muncie Community Schools.
This is a case where demand exceeds supply.
Yes. And so there is room and there is a need for multiple agencies to come together to help the families that need us most.
This is just such a wonderful program. Jason Newman, thank you so much for sharing the work of the Boys and Girls Clubs of Muncie. And thank you so much for your insights.
Thank you.